The bull will stop, causing a stock market crash in 2018. Will the stock market crash in 2018? Market crashes happen. They are supposed to be a normal part of the system. The problem is that we don't know when they happen. I don't have a crystal ball, so I do not think I can predict what will happen tomorrow in the markets, especially given that the current situation can be used to justify everything and its opposite. Yet, as many of you, I sense that a stock market crash in 2018, if not sooner, is likely. Inflation could accelerate, as so many are warning. But even if this happens, it will be a minor increase. Prices for goods will rise, but wages and salaries will not. We will not be able to buy or sell our way out of the correction. The minimum wage increase to $15 could, in theory, act like the tide that lifts all boats. Yet, there's a bigger chance that inflation might not rise officially. Unofficially, inflation has been increasing, considering that the bull market has been riding on Wall Street for almost 10 years. Sooner or later, the real economy will catch up to the financial markets. It will hurt when that happens. Millions will lose fortunes as a much-needed correction occurs. The economy is currently overheating. That's why a stock market crash is imminent. If you think about the future and the date of the next stock market collapse, you may not want to invest in the stock market. Private sector debt is increasingly high in the United States, but also in emerging markets such as China. Meanwhile, nothing is being done about debt. President Donald Trump wants to lift the restrictions on investment banks that Congress approved to prevent them from running into the same mistakes that contributed to the 2008 market crash. Yet, even the banks are worried about Trump's plans. The market outlook is gloomier and, historically, if the Federal Reserve raises rates in the US, it won't be long before the Europeans follow suit. The Chinese investment bubble can prove disastrous on its own. When you add the impact of the US bubble bursting, the stock market outlook becomes suddenly clearer. It also becomes suddenly gloomier. Many assets will be depreciated and we will begin to witness bank failures worldwide and no longer only in the United States. Inevitably, stock market predictions are going to be negative, considering all the major parts of the economic system are vacillating. The economic situation will be so degraded that beautiful women will marry beautiful men and not the rich. Take the case of the stock market. Although it is wise to take advantage of an economic crisis, it may be wiser to just not play the game, waiting for an event to invest. This is where the best deals are made. Now, the market is very high, it's actually too high, having surpassed pre-crisis valuations and setting historic records. Surely, there are stocks that are doing very well in times of economic crisis. But, it's difficult to determine which stocks will survive the upcoming stock market crash. That's because the causes of the next crash are inherent to the excessive price-to-earnings ratios of the stocks pulling the market. But, there are also other forces, political and economic, which carry the seeds of collapse. Watch those fangs. The investments in big data, given the digitization of our world, are like those words that sound familiar when you're learning a foreign language. You think you know their meanings, but you find out that it's not quite as clear. The so-called FAANG companies Facebook Inc., NASDAQ, FB, Apple Incorporated, NASDAQ, Apple, Amazon.com, Incorporated, NASDAQ, Amazon, Netflix, Incorporated, NASDAQ, NFLX, and Google, now known as Alphabet Inc., NASDAQ, Google, are like that. They promise big returns, because you use them. Your neighbors use them. Yet they are overvalued and expensive stocks. They also happen to be the locomotive's market-leading stocks. All it takes is for someone to point out that the proverbial emperor has no clothes on to bring them down to reality. One River Asset Management CIO, Eric Peters, is not wasting time. He has already seen the market is naked. When will the next stock market crash happen? The chief investment officer has marked the date on his calendar, Valentine's Day, 2018. This is not to remind him to buy flowers for his wife. Rather, this romantic occasion is when Peters expects the upcoming stock market crash. But this is no ordinary crash. Peters has described this potential event as nothing short of a market apocalypse. Investors have become soft. They have gotten used to the market moving in a single direction. Except for a few occasions, or corrections, any hint of a bearish trend has been cancelled. The point is, as Peter stresses, that investors are so numb to the bull market, they have no idea how to react when things start to go really bad. Mark the date, February 14, 2018. Peters expects nothing less than a veritable market avalanche on February 14, 2018. Source: it will be an avalanche. Hedge fund CIO sets the day when the next crash begins. Zero Hedge, June 26, 2017. But what will happen from now until Peters' fatal Valentine's Day date? Although Federal Reserve Chair Janet Yellen hinted she would be more flexible in considering rate hikes, the Fed might still increase rates as a matter of inflationary caution and to ease its balance sheet in an effort to stem financial instability. No doubt, Peter's perspective makes for some sleepless nights. He might be right, thus many investors will worry about cutting their losses and closing in on present gains rather than risk the financial apocalypse that could strike in February. Then again, as expert as he is, Peters might also be wrong. He could be wrong especially in two ways. He may have overshot the estimated date of the next stock market crash. Or he may have called it too early. In the first case, it adds more pressure on investors to break the bullish momentum, which has afflicted them for so long. In the second instance, acting before February 2018, that very same bullish thrust acts like the little voice in your head, encouraging you to hang on just a little bit longer to make that extra dollar. The fact is that the markets are long overdue for a massive correction. The correction risks turning into a major crash, which could trigger another recession not unlike what happened in 2008. The tech stocks that have dragged the huge Trump rally are at risk of breaking down. Consider the fate of Snap Inc. NYSE, Snap, better known as Snapchat. Snapchat is in the midst of its own personal stock market crisis. It could merely be the first salvo of the upcoming stock market crash. Snapchat has fallen below the IPO price of $17 per share to just over $15. In a single session in July, it lost 9%. The day after its IPO, March 2, 2017, Snap stock had touched $27.09. Since then, the decline is over 47%. But, as you ponder the fact that Snap lost almost 50% in less than half a year, remember what Snap does. It does not make airliners or cars. It doesn't even run an airline or a bus service. It is an electronic social media app with a quirky twist. In the grand scheme of things, if Facebook were an actual book, Snap might be a mere comma or at best a semicolon. The fact that investors have allowed themselves to become so numb as to drive Snap to a market cap rivaling exceeding target corporation NYSE, TGT, gives way to Peter's point. Last March, Snap actually traded higher than Kroger Co. NYSE, KR, American Airlines Group Inc., NASDAQ, AAL, and Harley-Davidson Inc., NYSE, HOG, among others. That's why you should pay attention to Peter's warning. Snap might be an exaggerated case, but it perfectly reflects the phenomenon, and the weakness, of the tech sector-driven market rally. It took a Morgan Stanley, NYSE, MS, report to bring down Snap rather than the most basic logic: how could a minor app be worth more than a legacy US company like American Airlines? At this point, it would be legitimate to object that Snap's massive drop was merely the market reacting to an overvalued stock. In normal circumstances, that would have been the start of a valid argument. But these are not normal times. There are many overvalued stocks, and the overall assumptions that have driven the bull market are being questioned. A bull market rarely occurs, much less survives, in political instability. If there's one thing that characterizes US politics now, it's instability. There are bookies in Brooklyn taking bets about President Trump's resignation. Some say he'll do it within a year, others sooner, and others are betting he'll be impeached. Considering that the 2018 congressional vote is just less than a year and a half away, the Republican Party, which has a majority of senators and representatives now, will want to take protective measures. They want to keep their majority. But, if Trump continues to divide the country, the the Republicans might join the Democrats in making life difficult for the president. That would turn the most dynamic sectors of American business in further against Trump. Already, the most dynamic CEOs and company leaders like Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos, who's also a majority shareholder of the highly anti-Trump The Washington Post, have done their utmost to make life difficult for President Trump. The divide in Washington could prompt Trump to take unnecessary risks to force some kind of partisan or bipartisan unity in order to consolidate his leadership. But, until then, the instability will make investors reflect about their investments. Such introspection will make many realize that the market is overheated. Even if they can manage to keep fear and panic under control, there's no telling how far down a market correction can reach. Buyers disappearing, stock market crash sooner rather than later? Decline in buyers suggest that a stock market crash is likely. Understand the basics. Stock markets go higher as long as there are more buyers than sellers. If this equation changes even a bit, and you end up with fewer buyers and the same number of sellers, a stock market crash follows. As it stands, we are seeing major buyers dissipate. With this, it's important for investors to be very careful and pay close attention to this phenomenon. Consider the companies traded on the key stock indices. They were the biggest buyers of their own stocks not too long ago. They spent their earnings to buy back shares. Low interest rates gave them an incentive to borrow money and buy back those shares. Now we see them pulling back from buying their own shares. Look at the S&P 500 companies. In the 12-month period ending on June 30th, S&P 500 companies bought $500.8 billion worth of their own shares. In the same period a year ago, this amount was $585.4 billion. This represents a decline of 14.5% year over year. Source: Q2 2017 S&P 500 buybacks fall 9.8% from Q1 to $120.1 billion. Puerto Rico Newswire, September 18, 2017. Going forward, it wouldn't be shocking to see companies on the key stock indices pulling back further on their stock buybacks. Why? Because interest rates are increasing. It would be a very bad business decision to borrow money to buy stocks as costs are increasing. When rates were kept artificially low by the Federal Reserve, it slightly made sense. Not anymore. Money managers ditching stocks. Here's the thing, companies traded on the major indices aren't the only buyers that are dissipating. Look at the so-called smart money as well, institutional investors. It seems that they don't like stocks whatsoever. In fact, it looks like they might be getting some sort of a stock market crash head. Please see the chart below. It's the National Association of Active Investment Managers, NAAM, Exposure Index. This index basically tells what percentage of active managers' portfolios consists of stocks. Chart courtesy of stockcharts.com. Stocks make less than half of active managers' portfolios. These managers had a sudden change of heart recently. In early October, their portfolios were near 100% stocks. Their stock holdings stand at their lowest level since March 2016. This was just after the sell-off that occurred in early 2016. What's next for the stock market? Dear reader, it is very easy to get lured into the idea that all is well and that there's not much to worry about. Do I think the bull market is about to end? I can't predict tops and bottoms. But, looking at how the buyers are dissipating, my conviction is that we may be closing in on a top, rather than being on the cusp of a major upside move. Key stock indices like the S&P 500 have soared close to 300% since the stock market crash of 2008 to 2009. With this in mind, I have constantly been asking one question, which I will ask again: could the index increase 300% from where it currently stands without any sort of pullback? For the S&P 500 to increase 300% from current levels, it would have to soar to roughly 7,878. Do you see it happening in the next 8 to 9 years? The economic situation will be so degraded that beautiful women will marry beautiful men and not the rich. Take the case of the stock market. Although it is wise to take advantage of an economic crisis, it may be wiser to just not play the game, waiting for an event to invest. This is where the best deals are made. Now, the market is very high. It's actually too high, having surpassed pre-crisis valuations and setting historic records. Surely, there are stocks that are doing very well in times of economic crisis. But, it's difficult to determine which stocks will survive the upcoming stock market crash. That's because the causes of the next crash are inherent to the excessive price-to-earnings ratios of the stocks pulling the market. But, there are also other forces, political and economic, which carry the seeds of collapse. Watch those. The bull will stop, causing a stock market crash in 2018. Will the stock market crash in 2018? Market crashes happen. They are supposed to be a normal part of the system. The problem is that we don't know when they happen. I don't have a crystal ball, so I do not think I can predict what will happen tomorrow in the markets, especially given that the current situation can be used to justify everything and its opposite. Yet, as many of you, I sense that a stock market crash in 2018, if not sooner, is likely. Inflation could accelerate, as so many are warning. But even if this happens, it will be a minor increase. Prices for goods will rise, but wages and salaries will not. Meanwhile, nothing is being done about debt. President Donald Trump wants to lift the restrictions on investment banks that Congress approved to prevent them from running into the same mistakes that contributed to the 2008 market crash. Yet, even the banks are worried about Trump's plans. The market outlook is gloomier and, historically, if the Federal Reserve raises rates in the US, it won't be long before the Europeans follow suit. The Chinese investment bubble can prove disastrous on its own. When you add the impact of the US bubble bursting, the stock market outlook becomes suddenly clearer. It also becomes suddenly gloomier. Many assets will be depreciated and we will begin to witness bank failures worldwide and no longer only in the United States. Inevitably, stock market predictions are going to be negative, considering all the major parts of the economic system are vacillating. The investments in big data, given the digitization of our world, are like those words that sound familiar when you're learning a foreign language. You think you know their meanings, but you find out that it's not quite as clear. The so-called FAANG companies Facebook Inc., NASDAQ, FB, Apple Incorporated, NASDAQ, Apple, Amazon.com, Incorporated, NASDAQ, Amazon, Netflix, Incorporated, NASDAQ, NFLX, and Google, now known as Alphabet Inc., NASDAQ, Google, are like that. They promise big returns, because you use them. Your neighbors use them. Yet they are overvalued and expensive stocks. They also happen to be the locomotive's market-leading stocks. All it takes is for someone to point out that the proverbial emperor has no clothes on to bring them down to reality. One River Asset Management. We will not be able to buy or sell our way out of the correction. The minimum wage increase to $15 could, in theory, act like the tide that lifts all boats. Yet, there's a bigger chance that inflation might not rise officially. Unofficially, inflation has been increasing, considering that the bull market has been riding on Wall Street for almost 10 years. Sooner or later, the real economy will catch up to the financial markets. It will hurt when that happens. Millions will lose fortunes as a much-needed correction occurs. The economy is currently overheating. That's why a stock market crash is imminent. If you think about the future and the date of the next stock market collapse, you may not want to invest in the stock market. Private sector debt is increasingly high in the United States, but also in emerging markets such as China.